Serious, people who like their job. What do? I think up and draw cartoons. Every day, a syndicated comic for newspapers. Only learned to draw at age 43, so it's been a cool midlife turn. I'm one of those handful of people trying to be at least a fraction of what Gary Larson was. Oh wow, you have just made my day. I just started taking drawing lessons at age 48. Would love to somehow make it into a kid's book. I have the ideas and the characters. Just need to draw them. All the best to you. I know the feeling. I've heard it said the best time to start is when you're 20. The second best time is tomorrow. I am a speech therapist working with stroke patients. I love rehab. I tried pediatrics but it was not my thing. Rehab is for me. Matt Painter for film. It's fun and lives at the intersection between having to have artistic talent and technical experience. Honestly, sometimes it can be maddening as I come from a creative background, traditional illustration and sculpture. So certain programs are like going from speaking French to speaking Chinese. But all in all, it's fun to see your work when it's composited into a film and get to see the shots before any VFX goes in. Frankly, it's surprising just how many movies use VFX, and I can assure you it's almost everything you've seen, including smaller independent films. Seaplane pilot charters, sightseeing, fly-in fishing, seaplane flight training. Now that is a cracking job. I am a freight dog on 737s. It's brilliant fun, but always wanted my seaplane rating. Whereabouts are you flying, if you don't mind me asking? I make replicas of dinosaur fossils for museum display. The company I work for does full-sized replicas, but I primarily work in the division that creates teeth and claw replicas, and a few scaled-down skull replicas for gift shops. I'm a night shift worker at a manufacturing facility. I love being able to set all my machines, read a book, or play on my 3DS, and be by myself. Once all my machines are set, I just need to change finished parts for new blanks every 15-20 minutes. Waste management. I drive a garbage truck. I start early but there are days I'm off at noon. A full 8 hours for me ends at 1:30 and I work 5 minutes from my house. I am in the AC all day and left alone. It's wonderful. My waste management truck driver is cool as hell. He drives up and says what's up every day, always enjoying a nice fat cigar. I started to appreciate those moments with cool people more often, even if it's just a few minutes or a simple what's up. Life can be stressful sometimes and you have to deal with people that you would like never met. My boys used to worship Mr. Ed, the man who picked up our trash each week. He even let one of them push the crusher button as a birthday gift once. Dude is a legend in our house. I can't explain why, but a garbage truck is the coolest thing in the world to a young boy. If I got to push the crusher button when I was a kid, I'd still be talking about it today. And I'm in my 30s. I'm a locomotive engineer. It's badass controlling thousands of horsepower and tons all with my hands. I love running with the window open, listening to the power working and waving at people when they wave with more than one finger. I'm in my late 30s and still get excited to give you guys and gals a wave. Trains are super cool. Facilities, a glorified janitor. The position has morphed. I started by cleaning floors and toilets. Now so many of my creative strengths are used. We're updating our campus. So we build furniture, construct new walls and stages, choose paint colors, engineer unique solutions for an aging campus, and so much more. I've learned electrical, concrete work, welding, sound engineering, drywall, installation of floors, ceilings, doors, stage backdrops, you name it. If something needs to be done, we get it done. I love it. Facilities manager here. You are right about the job morphing. Just remember the facilities motto: the last to know, the first to blame. Been doing it for 30 years. 17 years at GT in Atlanta. I can retire in 8 months. You sound like my brother. He was custodial at a culinary school and now does maintenance and facilities. It's not a respected job, but it can be so rewarding to see your hard work upgrade an environment many people use. I do have a bachelor's degree, but it was too social for me. I'd rather work with my hands and see the product of my work. Fulfillment. Before the pandemic shut everything down, I was a Broadway dresser. I got to work backstage on some awesome shows with pretty costumes and be a part of the magic. It was such a rewarding feeling. I'm a meteorologist. I look at weather all around the world and work directly with Fortune 500 companies to help them prepare for natural disasters. Considering I've wanted to be a meteorologist since I was 5, it's a dream come true and I feel blessed. I too dreamed of being a meteorologist as a child up through high school graduation. Everyone that knew me was aware of my passion for weather. However, as I planned to enroll in college, I became aware of the required advanced math classes totally tanked me. Couldn't hack the math, so I had to walk away, joined the medical profession. Lol. Still absolutely love following the weather. I get calls and texts from family friends throughout storm season. I live in Oklahoma, asking for my thoughts. Kudos for making it. Best wishes and blessings. Public library. Everything is free. I don't have to sell anything. People come in because they want to be there. I get to help people who want to be helped, or provide an environment where they can chill and relax. They only owe money when stuff is late. Librarian is my dream job, but it requires a minimum of a master's degree around my area. Mad respect for librarians. Apply anyway. You'd be surprised at how far you can get. We have librarians with business degrees that help people to business research, like market penetration and drafting loan applications. Your real world education and experience can be a real asset and make you more relatable when it comes to helping patrons and conducting programs. And when in doubt, ask to meet with the interviewer and get some tips on how to get in. The drive, curiosity, and persistence can pay off. And I just have a B.S. degree. So say we all. I'm a social worker. Currently I work with seniors who live alone with a disability and have no family to take care of them. I plan on getting my master's and becoming a therapist. After working construction for 8 years and getting a degree in business, I set effort and followed my passion regardless of what everybody in my life said. I am so effing glad that I made that decision. It was really hard to get myself into the mindset that it's not too late. Once I was there though, I wasn't leaving. I put my foot down and was determined. Went to a community college. Got 12 credits. Working an entry-level social work job and will be applying for my master's once this show of a pandemic is over. Or maybe when I cave and decide to do online classes. Either way, I feel like I'm living my dream. Even though I'm not nearly where I want to be. Yet. I work in a homeless shelter. I was homeless like 10 years ago and it feels good to help the marginalized community I was once a part of. Bless you. I work at a doggy daycare. I left vet teching after 12 years for something less stressful. Interesting. I work in technology and I was considering becoming a vet tech because I love animals and want to work with them one day. However, I've heard it is stressful. Could you elaborate? I think the part that I didn't realize would be so prevalent in vet teching is dealing with the owners of the pets. When it comes to their pets, mean people get meaner. Freelance illustrator and graphic designer. I've always liked the idea of making things that are useful to people in any way, and I always try to apply this mentality into my work. Not to mention that stimulating my creativity is something I've always enjoyed, and something this line of work requires on a constant basis. Of course, creative blocks are an issue occasionally, but it's still something I truly enjoy. I'm currently a factory worker making sheet metal roofing and siding. It's one of the easiest jobs I've ever had. The work is relatively repetitive, but there's enough variation to keep it from getting boring. The people I work with are kind and funny. Management actually gives a shit about us, and the benefits are fantastic. I love working manual labor. I could never have a desk job. Park ranger. I work for the National Park Service. I started off seasonal and got to visit 6 different national parks, getting paid to live people's vacation and be in most beautiful places. Now I am settled permanently on the National Mall where I get to work with special events, getting to see firsthand all the amazing events that go on in Washington DC and be a part of it all. I have worked in zoos my entire career, mostly as a zookeeper, and now get to travel and work in conservation. Incredibly gratifying and truly feel I have never worked a day in my life with this career. I'm a loss prevention person at Burlington. All I do is stand at the door, wipe off carts, and say hi and bye to people coming in or out. Easiest job in the world. Most of my co-workers hate me for the job. So you're the guy who ignores the alarm going off when I walk out? I'm not a thief. I just somehow trigger alarms. Yup. Alarms might go off because of a certain clothing or bag you have on still has a sensor. Happens to a lot of girls with expensive small backpacks or purses. Architecture during quarantine. I was doing 60 to plus 90 hours a week. The only thing holding me was my passion for the profession. Server bartender. IDK, everyone sees it as something they want to get out of. I can't see the wisdom in getting a career in a growing and stable field. But I honestly enjoy it. The craziness. The good guests, the bad guests. People having fun being super inappropriate. People being pissed off for something that really doesn't matter. It's a lot of fun. And for the most part, you're in control over how much money you make. Even if I find a big boy job, I'd still try and work some shifts at a bar or restaurant. Pay for groceries, gas, and have fun doing it. I'm a server, and one of my favorite parts that nobody usually talks about is everyone getting pissed over shit that doesn't matter at all. Like, lady at table 22 ordered in a slightly annoying way. F-ing-C, I hope she dies. I'm a data analyst. I set up and maintain a large amount of data flowing into a database and process it so that it's usable within BI tools and for machine learning projects. Then after it's in a good format, I use BI tools to make cool visualizations so that a few couple hundred users who want different things from this data can all go in and be able to find what they need efficiently. Sometimes I also get to do some machine learning projects. It inside a hospital. I go out if something breaks or redeploy PCs for new practices, etc. Everyone appreciates me and the pay and benefits are great. I teach history and government at a small rural high school. My students are extremely polite and respectful. It's not often the younger generation calls their elders. So, I love what I teach. And I get along with all of my co-workers. Hell yeah, I have a BA in history. Question. How do you think COVID and the current administration will be taught in the history books decades from now? Objectively speaking, I think it will be treated how the Spanish flu currently is. As far as the current administration, I think there's still too many unknown variables to consider. The outcome of November, one way or the other, will set the stage for what historians will write. It's certainly an unconventional administration no matter which way one looks at it. Reading through these, it seems most people who like their job like it because they work with good people and have good managers. I'm a city bus driver and I adore my job. It doesn't feel like I'm working. Feels like I'm doing people favors. Can you give me a ride to the doctors? Can you give me a ride to work? Can you take my cat to the vet? I make personalized gene vaccines for cancer patients. I'm a sales executive for a utility company. It's a job that most people imagine would be soul-crushing, but I genuinely enjoy it. That's not to say it doesn't have its bad moments, but it's mostly pretty fun. Plus, it's a relatively well-paid job in a very recession-proof industry. So at the moment, I'm effing grateful to have a stable job. As a rather solitary person who doesn't particularly like people trying to talk to me, I take a perverse satisfaction in a job where I spend my day trying to talk to people who don't want to talk to me. I teach college and I love it so much. I get paid well to conduct daily TED Talks on topics I love discussing. I also love public speaking and these students pay thousands to listen to me tell stories. I also show an episode of The Office during class, which is my favorite show. It also feels great to ask a student for a meeting and ask them how you can help their mental load, and then giving them the thing they need. It's like Oprah, everyone gets an extension. I don't quite give them away, but when I can make reasonable adjustments to help someone, I always do. I am constantly surprised I am paid for this gig. This will probably get buried, but I'm a winemaker. Plenty of cool things about it, especially if you actually enjoy drinking wine. I'm a kennel worker. Every day I clean out the kennels, feed, play and cuddle dogs and cats of all cuddly shapes and sizes. I make sandwiches. I like to do stuff with my hands. Software engineering. I love designing logic and solving problems with code. It can be pretty frustrating sometimes, but highly rewarding afterwards. I direct an academic library. It's a small operation, so I get to do every task. I help with research queries. I help direct statewide purchasing strategies. Pre-COVID, we had a robust chess club and we put out Girl Scout cookies year-round. For right now, the library is closed due to COVID. So essentially, I'm being paid to go back to grad school and develop my skill set. Also, I'm finishing a history book that uses originally researched biographies as a scaffold to explore how research is done. It's melding genealogy and historiography with interdisciplinary contextual research. Publishers, hit me up. The how is just as important as the why, maybe more. So it's a good story, but I sneak a lot of instruction in there about skills, techniques, and critical thinking. I'm finishing the story of the whiniest sailor in the US Navy currently, and it's a blast dealing with a person with such terrible character. Senior Clinical Research Associate, Oncology. I switch projects every few years and get to learn new indications very thoroughly. My background is molecular biology, and when I get the right projects I really love what I do. Unfortunately, there is a ton of paperwork and regulation involved, and I spend a lot of time writing reports. I sell wedding dresses. Software developer, and I absolutely love my job. I literally can't say one bad thing about it. I don't even have a degree, and I learned everything on my own. Yup, I think the reason why we like it so much is because we taught ourselves. Given how bad the education system is where I am, I'd say my interest in computers survived college. I feel bad for a lot of people who probably had their interest ruined by the curriculum. I'm a drug and alcohol recovery worker in a prison, and I love it. The biggest thing I've learned is that some of these men just never had the chance to succeed. So many were born into abusive, addicted families, so drugs and crime is all they've ever known. But many of them are so kind and funny. They just never got the right opportunities in life, which is where I come in. Public defender. My job is incredibly frustrating and frequently rage-inducing. But sometimes every once in a while I get to touch someone's life in a good way. Those moments make it all worthwhile. I'm a doctor specializing in emergency medicine and sub-specializing in pre-hospital emergency care helicopter emergency medical services. I blend, back, package and ship coffee at a local roastery. I'm the entire crew except the roaster. It's the absolute best job in the world, and has made me into a total coffee snob, but I love it. I'm a CNA. I wipe bay and give hugs. I'm a nurse that currently oversees a geriatric memory care unit, but my passion is special needs and geriatrics, the elderly. I love nothing more than making people who have special needs or memory care disabilities happy and feeling better. It fills my heart emotional battery more than it drains it. Their smiles, their laughs, their brief moments of lucidity and joy in what memories make them feel happy again. I would gladly dodge punches, scratches, verbal aggression, out of fear and confusion, every day for those fleeting but brightly burning moments of happiness in their lives. I'm an oyster farmer right now. Early mornings like 3 a.m, 6 a.m, 7 a.m, sometimes 2 a.m. But you get out hanging baskets, lifting lines. I get to see the sunrise over my bay in town 5 days a week. Lifting lines, you can see the oysters opening and closing, and you're reminded that you're helping millions of these little guys grow. Some days the harbor is like glass. I've seen a pod of dolphins swimming along the boat just under the surface of the water, less than 20 centimeters from my hand. Sea lions, starfish chilling out, jelly boys. That combined with a good crew makes the early mornings worth it. There's some days there's wind, there's rain, the tide's up, so you're swimming whilst trying to hang baskets or throw baskets, which is surprisingly difficult. Treading water with your feet and holding 5-10 kilogram baskets above your head and throwing them 5-10 feet. It's a really good job. Corporate accounting. I love working with numbers and with Excel, so the job is a natural fit for me. Also, being work from home since March has made the job even better. I can wake up 5 minutes before work starts and never be late. The job I loved, retail at an adult store. On an almost daily basis I could be helping an 18-year-old just start the discovery of what they wanted, to helping a 70-year-old grandma find something to stave off the effects of menopause. Side note, the grandmas were always the best. No shame, no fears, and would flirt and joke with us constantly. I served 10 years in the military, and that one job selling sex toys, I probably did more to help that community than in 10 years in uniform ever truly helped them as individuals. Disability service worker. Musician. Composer. Instructor. Conductor. Performer. Pipe organ. Piano. Concert harp. Aerospace engineer. I design fighter jets and satellites for a living. I work with female indigenous youth on an island a ferry ride away from my home. We paint, do crafts, go for walks and talk. Today I picked berries, painted in a grassy field, and found baby crabs on the beach. Teacher. Many people say teachers love it for the perks, summers off and such. Yeah, that's cool. But there is something so incredibly satisfying about turning that light bulb on in a student's head. When kids tell you you're their favorite teacher, you're the one that they can talk to and is there for them, you're the one who makes them laugh, it means the world. We often forget that kids growing up nowadays have it really hard. Social media really isn't helping at all. However, in this line of work I'm really able to make a positive impression upon these kids, and for the 43 minutes that they're in my class they can forget about all that and smile. And I teach history, so I'm able to talk about some cool stuff along the way. I make chili con queso, and salsa and pepper jellies and stuff. I'm a tattoo artist, still technically an apprentice. I love using my talent to make people happy and look badass. For those who are wondering the common question, what is my weirdest tattoo? Well, I'd have to say they were all pretty normal. I did cover up a prison tattoo that was done with a needle and graphite melted in water, so that was a thing. Teacher. Although this coming school year is causing a fair amount of anxiety. I'm a nurse. It's physically and mentally demanding at times, but I feel very fulfilled. This will sound sad, but at the moment I'm enjoying working as a delivery driver. For clarity, I work for a wage unlike, say, food delivery couriers who are paid piecemeal. It's well below my education level, a BA, second degree in progress, and it's nowhere near my passions. Information security. I enjoy the job mainly because I'm gaining rapid familiarity with where I live. I get to see small businesses I didn't know existed, like the local place that grows awesome bonsai trees, and interesting houses. I now know which roads are arterials, where they start and end, and which seemingly major roads are utter garbage. Every delivery driver I know loves their job. What is up with that? You get to sit in your car most of the time and listen to sweet jams. I delivered for FedEx Express for years and I met people from all walks of life, just like OC. Here's why: you're alone. No management to bother you or look over your shoulder. You manage your route and run it like you want. See the same cool people every day and build relationships. The pay is good. Well, was for me. You're outside. And TBHIDK what it is, but for me I just lived delivering mail. I delivered cancer medication before. The lady told me it was for her husband and it had been late. I didn't open the package, and the look on her face and her thank you just keeps me going throughout my day, especially during the holidays. Seeing a mom rush out to trying to hide stuff before their kids saw. ESL teacher working with refugees and immigrants. I'm lead singer in a band. P won't reveal the band name, but we are big enough here in Ireland, and in the UK we have an American tour next year, so let's hope that goes well too. I make a fairly good income writing songs and then just singing them. Couldn't ask for more, to be honest. I am a fish and game officer in the Northwest. I never wanted to be law enforcement, but I didn't like lab work and I didn't want to go to school for a master's. I really enjoy helping preserve our resources for the next generations. And I will admit I love giving tickets out to people who litter. Unlike most law enforcement I imagine, I deal with people who are generally out enjoying nature and are happy to be out and about. I work in a sex toy shop with a focus on sexual health and proper BDSM. It's an incredibly rewarding job and there's never a boring day.